Hello learners, today we'll look at the novel David Copperfield by Charles Dickens. However, before looking at the various details of the novel, we'll learn a bit more about the author. The author of the novel, Charles Dickens, was born in the year 1812. He had a troubled childhood. His father, John Dickens, did not know how to manage his income and due to that borrowed from his friends and acquaintances. He was not able to pay these debts and landed in a debtor's prison. Due to this, Charles, at a young age, had to work in a blacking factory. While at the factory, Charles underwent various hardships and he found the various problems that child labor faced. John Dickens had an inheritance and due to that, he was able to repay his debts. Charles got out of the factory and went to school. He graduated and became a law clerk. After working as a law clerk, Charles became a reporter and worked for various newspapers. In 1837, Charles Dickens tried his hand at literature. He wrote Pickwick Papers and it became an immense success. The novel was a success with the Victorian reader because the readers found the plot engaging and the characters entertaining and amusing. After this novel, Charles Dickens wrote 19 more novels and altogether he wrote 20 novels. All of these were popular with the Victorian readers. Of these, quite a few are even popular today. Some of his more popular novels are Bleak House, Oliver Twist, A Tale of Two Cities, Great Expectations and David Copperfield. Charles Dickens in his novels created characters which are more of caricatures. Although these are not three-dimensional in any sense, these characters had lots of appeal to the reader and people loved his novels for the reason that they were entertaining. In the reason for Dickens creating these characters and these characters could showcase the problems in society. While working in the blacking factory or as a reporter, Dickens had found various problems in society. These problems he highlighted in his novels. For instance, in Oliver Twist, he showed the problems that are inherent in an orphanage. Similarly, in Bleak House, he depicted the problems that are present in the Court of Chancery. This criticism, however, is never bitter. These stories have lots of humor and the reader is never left with this feeling of despair. Due to this, his novels have an audience, have readership even in the modern day. The Victorian novel is particularly significant. The novel as a genre became popular in the 18th century. But it was in the 19th century, in the Victorian era, that the novel attained its pride of place. And Dickens had a major hand in this. Not only his plots, which depicted the various problems in society, even his characters are still remembered. Ebenezer Scrooge, Fagin, Bill Sykes are some of the characters that people remember to this day. The present novel, David Copperfield, is highly autobiographical and Dickens' personal favorite. David Copperfield tells the story of David. This is narrated in the first person and it traces the story of David from his birth to his maturity. Now, David is an orphan at a young age. Even before he's born, his father passed away and he basically grows up with his mother. His mother and his housekeeper Peggotty love him a lot. However, his mother marries when David is 7 years old. His stepfather, Mr. Edward Murdstone, does not like David and on the pretext of discipline, punishes him. Murdstone's sister Jane, who moves in with Dave's family, when the marriage happens, also punishes David. Now David faces these problems with lots of stoicness and puts up with all these harsh realities that he has to come to face in his childhood. After a particularly severe thrashing from his stepfather, David bites him. Due to this, David is sent to Salem House, where he encounters the strict disciplinarian, Mr. Creakle. Creakle punishes David on the pretext of disciplining him, just as his stepfather used to do. However, it's at Salem House that David meets his two of his lifelong friends, Steerforth and Tommy Traddles. While David comes home for holidays, and while at home, he knows that his mother had given birth to a baby brother. However, his mother and his baby brother soon pass away, and David is taken out of school. Mr. Murdstone, his stepfather, claims that this is a way of actually making David realize the harsh realities of life and making a man out of him. He is sent to London and David is put to work. He starts basically working in a bottling factory. There in London, he meets Mr. Micawber, who is his landlord. David befriends Micawber, as the latter is a genial person, though he too has no clue of how to manage his money. Micawber's problems with money soon result in him landing in the debtor's prison, and David is left without any friend in London. Due to this, David runs away. He runs away from London to his great aunt, Miss Betsy Trotwood in Dover. He had never seen her before, but had heard of her when his mother had spoken of her, saying that she had walked out of the house because she was angry that David was not a girl. He runs off to his aunt and asks her to take care of him. Mrs. Betsy takes pity on him, likes him, and decides to look after him. However, Mr. Murdstone doesn't leave him. He follows him to Dover and asks Miss Trotwood to return the baby. Betsy Trotwood refuses to hand over David to his stepfather and takes care of him. She sends him to school. While at school, David stays with Mr. Wickfield. He meets Mr. Wickfield's daughter, Agnes, there, and they both become friends. At the same time, he also meets Uriah Heep, who is a secretary to Mr. Wickfield. After his schooling, David starts working for Mr. Spenlow. He falls in love with Spenlow's daughter, Dora, and despite her father's objection, they marry. However, the young couple soon face lots of problems. Dora is pampered, she is childish and immature, and has no clue of household duties. She is extremely frivolous. Due to this, the household is always short of money. However, they somehow manage. Meanwhile, David's friend Steerforth seduces Peggotty's relative Emily on the eve of her marriage. He then dumps her. David and Peggotty's relatives finally trace her and they move to Australia. David's wife, Dora, meanwhile passes away. After she passes away, David is depressed and he decides to try his hand at writing. He goes off for a few years and comes back a successful novelist. Meanwhile, he realizes that his aunt had lost all her money and that Uriah Heep had swindled Mr. Wickfield. Along with Mr. Micawber and her aunt's help, Mr. Dick, he figures out the problems that Uriah Heep had caused and solves them. After that, David realizes that Agnes was in love with him all this while. They marry, and the novel ends with David living happily, now a mature person and a successful author, and in a happy marriage. This is the summary of David Copperfield. As we can see in the story, we can see David growing from an innocent childhood through various problems to maturity, where he is able to tackle problems on his own, not only tackle his own problems but also help others like his aunt and Mr. Wickfield. Engaging, like other Dickens novels, even David Copperfield has a host of characters that are endearing and stay in the reader's memory for a long while. The narrator and the protagonist, David himself, is an extremely endearing character. David comes across when we first meet him as a young boy. Of course, this story is related after a long period after David has attained maturity. So, this dual perspective also helps us in getting a better understanding of David. We get to know how David used to behave in a naive, innocent manner as a child, and how later his maturity after becoming an adult is reflected as he reflects on his childhood incidents. So, this dual perspective lends credence to an understanding of his character. We get a three-dimensional character due to this. David is a young boy at the beginning of the novel. He faces his stepfather's harsh treatment. He basically undergoes various troubles at his school and in the factory, and then finds love and security at his aunt's place. We are shown that he is resourceful even at a young age as he runs away from the factory from London to Dover and his aunt's place. In other words, from harsh reality to security. This resourcefulness is apparent even later in his life when he tackles Uriah Heep. Other important characters in this novel are Edward Murdstone and Uriah Heep. Edward Murdstone, David's stepfather, is the villain in the first half of the novel. He is someone who likes being harsh with people who are helpless. He treats David and his mother, both of them, in an extremely harsh manner. He says that he is disciplining them, he is teaching them how to handle life, how to be better. But actually what he is doing is bullying them, basically, and in various ways thrashing them and torturing them. Due to this, we can call him a sadist. Similarly, Uriah Heep is the villain in the second half of the novel. He is the villain in David's mature years. He is not an obvious villain as Murdstone is. Whereas Murdstone, from the very beginning, comes across as a harsh person and as a bully. Uriah Heep, in the beginning of the novel, when we first meet him, comes across as someone who is very humble. Of course, David does not like him even then. But we think it's just childish prejudice because Uriah Heep has red hair and red eyebrows and looks like a snake. However, it's not just that Uriah Heep looks like a snake or wriggles like a snake, but is a snake in real life too. He swindles Wickfield, who had helped him all along, and he also takes pleasure in making others feel bad just for the sake of doing so. He desires Agnes just because David wants to marry her. He basically ill-treats Wickfield when he finds that the latter is helpless in the later part of the novel. However, both Murdstone and Uriah Heep have to face comeuppance for their activities. Murdstone, later in the novel, is kicked out by Betsy Trotwood when he tries to reclaim David, and Uriah Heep lands in the prison at the end of the novel. Is a different matter altogether that neither character changes. In that sense, neither has redeeming characteristics and are more of caricatures than three-dimensional characters. These are the three main characters in David Copperfield. Now, looking at other major characters in David Copperfield, we have characters such as James Steerforth, David's friend, Miss Betsy Trotwood, David's great aunt, Dora Spenlow, David's first wife, and Agnes Wickfield, David's second wife. James Steerforth is the primary bad influence on David. He is a friend that David acquires at Salem House. He is in awe of him. He thinks Steerforth is wonderful because of the way he dresses and the way he behaves. He does not realize that Steerforth is a bully and is someone who basically is just a show-off. He only realizes this much later in the novel when Steerforth seduces Emily and dumps her. And these two are on the eve of Emily's marriage. Thus, when David realizes how heartless Steerforth is, then he makes sense of the various bad habits that he had learned from Steerforth, whether the amount that he spent, living beyond his means, showing off, all these things were things that he had acquired from Steerforth. He gets rid of these bad habits, and David decides that Steerforth was never his friend. Miss Betsy Trotwood, on the other hand, is a major good influence on David Copperfield. She is his great aunt. Yes, it's true that she left his house and walked out when David was born because she wanted a girl child. Although she's an eccentric person, she loves David, and when David goes to her in Dover for safety, for security, she immediately shows her warm side. She takes pity on this homeless orphan and looks after him. Not only David, she also looks after Mr. Dick, an eccentric and actually a slightly mad young man. Betsy Trotwood takes the advice of Mr. Dick for every single thing, and by doing so, makes Dick feel that he is important, that he is useful. She is considerate enough to realize that Dick feels that he is useless. This warm side of Betsy Trotwood comes across only when people know her better. Otherwise, she comes across as an eccentric old lady and who doesn't tolerate fools at all. David Copperfield's first wife, Dora Spenlow, is a problematic character. She is sweet, she is very beautiful, and David loves her a lot. Dora also loves David, but the problem is she realizes that she is frivolous, that she is pampered, that she is not actually looking after David the way she should, but she doesn't do anything about it. She doesn't look after David, she doesn't look after David's household. Due to this, the tradespeople cheat them on a regular basis. Dora, however, never learns. The problems that occur in David's household due to this are numerous. However, David and Dora are quite happy with each other for the simple reason that they are madly in love with each other. On the whole, Dora is not a malicious person or a vicious person. She is just someone that David loved, or rather was infatuated with, but who is a child and was very immature. Compared to this, David's second wife, Agnes, whom he marries at the end of the novel, comes across as a very mature person, even when she is a child. We are introduced to Agnes when David lives in Mr. Wickfield's home. While he stays at Mr. Wickfield's home, he realizes that Agnes is the housekeeper. The little daughter, Mr. Wickfield, looks after the whole household chores. She takes care of the budget, she takes care of how Mr. Wickfield looked, dressed, ate, and everything. That she was mature even at that age shows her immense good sense. Now, Agnes is the primary good influence on David. She encourages him when he's doing something noble and discourages him in his friendship with Steerforth and his petty ways. David's acts of tenderness come from what he has learned from Agnes. These are the major characters in David Copperfield. The other characters such as Tommy Traddles and Mr. Micawber and Mr. Dick, who help in moving the story along. Mr. Micawber is David's landlord in London. Due to him, David learns the importance of money and how one should manage one's income. Not only this, Micawber returns later in the novel and he does his bit to help Wickfield. He also helps in defeating Uriah Heep. Tommy Traddles is the other friend that David acquires at Salem House. He is in a sense the antithesis of Steerforth. He is not a show-off, but he is a true friend, and at the end of the novel, he along with Micawber expose Uriah Heep. Mr. Dick, the eccentric, slightly mad young person that Betsy Trotwood looks after, is a very genuine person. David learns from him that one does not need to be extremely intelligent or educated to be good. Dick helps Mr. and Mrs. Strong. He also helps Mr. Wickfield towards the end of the novel and comes across as a genuinely warm person. All these characters make David Copperfield a novel that readers can identify with even today and enjoy even in the present day. David Copperfield is Charles Dickens' personal favorite, and he had incorporated lots of autobiographical elements in the novel. In fact, critics say that David Copperfield is a mirror image of Charles Dickens, because David Copperfield's initials are DC and Charles Dickens' initials are CD. However that may be, there are some autobiographical elements in the novel. For instance, Mr. Micawber is inspired by Dickens' father, John Dickens. He does not know how to manage his money, just like Dickens' dad, and he faces various problems and lands in debtor's prison. Similarly, the difficulties that Charles Dickens faced by as a child are mirrored in the various problems that David Copperfield faces as a child. Both of them end up working in a factory and face various problems. And both finally become authors, successful ones at that. These are various autobiographical elements that we see in this novel. Along with the autobiographical elements in the novel, the plot, the characters, the setting, all this make this novel very endearing to readers. And it's not just lay readers who are enchanted by this novel. Even novelists such as the Russian stalwarts Leo Tolstoy and Fyodor Dostoevsky liked this novel. Dostoevsky apparently read this novel while in prison and found solace in it, and Tolstoy considered it as the greatest and the best of Dickens' novels. Similarly, Henry James is nostalgic about this novel and talks about how he heard his mother reading out this novel as a child. Virginia Woolf, Charlotte Bronte, James Joyce are others who are influenced by this novel and are fans of this novel. Now, considering the popularity of this novel, we can say that it had led to quite a few imitations. One of these is a parody that's done in James Joyce's Ulysses. The other element that we need to look at regarding this novel is that it's a Bildungsroman and a Kunstroman. Now, what's a Bildungsroman? A Bildungsroman is a German term to show that someone grows up in a novel. It shows a child attaining maturity in a novel. And of course, we can see that David Copperfield is a growing up novel in that sense. Other growing up novels are Henry Fielding's Tom Jones, which was written in the 18th century. But it's not just a Bildungsroman, but also a Kunstroman. David Copperfield not just shows a young boy growing into maturity and adulthood, but it also shows a young person becoming an artist. Kunstroman is a German term to say that it's an artist novel. How a person grows up and becomes an artist. James Joyce, A Portrait of the Artist as a Young Man, is a good example of this. As David also grows up to become a novelist, we can say David Copperfield is a Kunstroman. In this section, we had looked at Charles Dickens' life, his works, the story of David Copperfield, the major characters in David Copperfield, and how it's a Kunstroman, how it's a Bildungsroman, and the autobiographical elements in this novel. In the next section, we'll look at various themes, motifs, symbols, and the setting of the novel. These would help us to get a better understanding of the novel. Thank you.